Hello everybody, welcome to Pharma Education. Today our topic is computer-aided biopharmaceutical characterization. We will discuss introduction, in silico model and ACAT models here. Okay, this is a part 1 video. Okay, there will be part 2 or part 3 videos in coming future. Okay, this chapter is very much important and you may get one question from this chapter, and the ACAT model is very much important for your exam purpose. Okay, so introduction. If you all of you know that what is the drug discovery process and how much the time it takes. Okay, it's a very time consuming and laborious process. Okay, so in drug discovery there are certain phases, like first you have to identify the target, then you have to validate the target, then you have to synthesize, or you have to isolate some compounds or prepare some compounds to reach or to go to the target or to treat the disease or to treat the target. Okay, this is the basic fundamental. But in reality thousands of compounds are synthesized to treat the target, to hit the target, but few of them have the capacity to go to the preclinical trial. Those compounds are known as the leading compounds. Okay, so in drug discovery phase, the drug discovery phase takes huge time. Okay, but if you think about a system, in which the thousands of compounds will be created virtually and their biopharmaceutical assessment will be there, that will be also on virtual. Okay, so there is a huge chance to get success, and this chapter, computer-aided biopharmaceutical characterization, this chapter tells this story, how a drug molecule, a virtual drug molecule, will be assessed on basis of their pharmaceutical or biopharmaceutical characteristics, or the pharmacokinetic profile of a virtual compound will be assessed. How the pharmacokinetic profile of a virtual compound will be assessed, this chapter tells this story. Okay, introduction. Biopharmaceutical assessment of drug is of crucial importance in different phases of drug discovery and development. Yes, it's a very important. Drug absorption from GI tract is a complex process. There are several number of factors like physicochemical factor, then physiological factor, etc. Those factors are involved in the process of drug absorption, drug distribution. Okay, in silico model, what are the in silico models? In silico models are the models, those actually predict the pharmacokinetic profile of orally administered drugs. Okay, all are done on virtual basis. Okay, they offer potential to screen virtual compounds. Okay, they require very less amount of time and less amount of investment. Okay, in silico models can be also applied to predict oral drug absorption when the conventional pharmacokinetic assessment or analysis is limited. Okay, this is the drug discovery and development phase slide. I have already discussed it. Okay, then in silico models, there are several in silico models are there, like CAT, I mean compartmental absorption and transit model. Then ADAM means advanced dissolution absorption and metabolism model. Then GITA means GI transit and absorption model. Then ACAT model means advanced CAT model, advanced compartmental absorption and transit model. This ACAT model is very much important for your exam purpose. There are several softwares out there. These softwares actually simulate the GI absorption process, the absorption process throughout the GIT, and they actually made on ACAT model or GITA model or some other in silico models. Okay, we will discuss here gastro plus software is a software which deals with the absorption, GI absorption throughout the absorption process throughout the GIT, and which is made on the principle of ACAT model. Okay, then what is ACAT model? ACAT model is a model or in silico model which actually describes the absorption process throughout the GIT, and according to this model there are total 9 compartments in our body from which the absorption can take place. Okay, the compartments are like stomach, duodenum, jejunum, two jejunums are there, means jejunum has been divided into two parts in this model. Ileum has been divided into three parts, and cecum and colon, total 9 parts are there according to this model, and from these 9 parts drug can be absorbed. Okay, then this model also describes the drugs into 4 phases. Okay, 4 stage or phases, like see, drug can be present into the formulation, it may or may not release. If the drug is released, then okay, but if the drug is not released, then this state is known as unreleased. Then this stage is known as unreleased. And then this stage is known as unreleased. If the stage is released, means if the drug is released from the formulation but not dissolved into the body fluid, then it is known as undissolved. If the drug is released from the formulation and dissolves in the body fluid, then it is known as dissolved state. And if the drug is released from the formulation and it dissolves and it absorbed, then it is known as absorbed. Okay, so there are 4 stages of the drug. Okay, ACAT model considers these 4 stages. Okay, so go to the next slide. This is the picture of mechanistic approach of ACAT model. Okay, this picture is very much important for your exam purpose. If the question comes from ACAT model, then you have to definitely draw this picture. You have to just remember the direction of the directions, I mean which is bidirectional, which is unidirectional. You have to remember this. Okay, so in this picture you can easily see that total 9 compartments are there. Total 9 compartments are there. You can see stomach is there, jejunum is there, duodenum is there. Total 9 components are there. These are the components. This is one component. This is another. Okay. The columns are the components. And you can see that there are 4 stages of the drugs have been defined. Like unreleased, undissolved, dissolved, erythrocytes, I mean absorbed drug. Total 4 stages of the drug have been defined, and total 9 compartments have been defined. Okay, you can easily see that drugs from each compartment can go to the liver directly, or they can go to the central compartment. From liver it can also go to the central compartment, but directly it also can go to the central compartment. Okay, so this is the ACAT model. In brief, I can say the ACAT model is most useful model to predicting the absorption simulation in our body. Okay, ACAT model is very much important to simulate, to describe the absorption process through our body. Okay, so there are total 9 compartments are there and total 4 phases are there. Okay, so this is the pictorial view, mechanistic approach of ACAT model. One more thing, ACAT model is a mechanistic model, it's not a empirical model. Okay, and here are the some points about ACAT model. Absorption rate constant depends on the drug effective permeability multiplied by an absorption scale factor. Okay, see, the absorption rate constant depends on the drug permeability. I mean, what is absorption? Absorption means the entry of the blood, entry of the drug into the blood. Okay, then to entry inside the blood vessel, the drug have to pass the lipid bilayer, I mean the cell membrane. That depends on the drug's permeability efficiency or the degree of permeability. Okay, depending on the degree of permeability, drugs can enter into the blood vessel. Okay, so absorption rate constant is defined as the multiplication of permeability with ASF, I mean absorption scale factor. What is absorption scale factor? Absorption scale factor is the changes in the permeability due to changes in the physiological conditions along the GI tract. Okay, depending on the different physiological conditions, permeability may be changed, and that change is corrected by absorption scale factor. And absorption rate constant is the multiplication of permeability with absorption scale factor. Okay, besides passive absorption including both transcellular and paracellular routes, the ACAT model also accounts for influx and outflux transport processes. Okay, see, in this model total 9 components are there, sorry, total 9 compartments are there. ACAT model describes, or ACAT model considers each compartment for absorption. I mean, see, from take one compartment like stomach, there are some influx processes in stomach and efflux processes in stomach. Let's say 10 molecules are taking, body is taking 10 molecules from stomach and releasing 5 molecules. Then influx, the amount of influx is 10 and the amount of efflux is 5. Then what is the summation? What is the net influx, net absorption? Influx minus outflux or efflux, I mean 5. 10 minus 5, total 5. 5 is the absorption. So that is how the ACAT model considers the each processes, each influx and outflux processes in each individual compartments, and the total summation of all compartments is the total amount of absorption. Okay, so finally, the rates of absorption and exhaustion depend on the concentration gradients across the apical and basolateral erythrocyte membranes. Okay, the total amount of absorbed drugs is summed over the integrated amounts being absorbed and exhausted from each absorption or transit compartment. Okay. Once the drug passes through the basolateral membrane of the erythrocyte, enterocytes, it reaches to the portal vein, okay, and liver. After that, it will go to the hepatic circulation. I mean, it will go to the fast metabolism. See, in this picture, you can easily see that after liver, the drug is going to the central compartment. And before reaching to the liver, the absorbed drugs, the enterocyte. Enterocyte means absorbed drugs. After absorbed, the drugs are coming to the liver, hepatic circulation, or directly to the central compartment. Okay, so this is the process what I have written here. Once the drug passes through the basolateral membrane, once the drug is absorbed, it reaches to the portal vein and the liver, where it can undergo the fast pass metabolism. From the liver, it goes into the systemic circulation, from where the ACAT model is connected to either a conventional pharmacokinetic model or a physiologically based pharmacokinetic model. Okay, the softwares, advanced softwares, GastroPlus, recent versions of GastroPlus uses ACAT as well as PBPK model, physiologically based pharmacokinetic models. They use ACAT plus PBPK model to simulate better simulation. Okay, so hope you have understood the ACAT model and in what is in silico model and drug discovery process, the brief review on drug discovery process, what is in silico model and their advantages, and the basic introduction. Okay, so one question you can definitely get from this chapter, and the question will be, write a note on ACAT model. ACAT model is very, very important, and this is my reference. And one more thing, I am very much thankful to my professor Dr. Falguni Fatro. Some of the slides in this video have taken from him. Okay, so this is the acknowledgement, and thank you.